StudyItOnline.com.
We have a band in here. We got a great email. Bad Seed Rising has some exciting news. You've had them in studio twice before, and now these kids, and when we say kids, we mean kids, are very close to signing a major record deal. They have an EP of all original music they wrote and recorded in the Foo Fighters studio with Foo Fighters producer Lou Lustau and a new music video. They killed it at Charm City Music Festival. They won Island Bay Day Battle of the Bands on Friday against four adult bands. Look at that.
Oh, nice. God.
And they'll be at Mother's on October 26th as the entertainment for the Ravens Cheerleaders annual Rock the House charity event at Rams Head Live on November 30th. So here they are, Bad Seed Rising.
Hey, guys.
What up?
How are you?
What up?
Excuse me. Guys, how long has it been since you've been up here? Guys and gals, sorry.
It's been
a couple months.
And tell me your name again. I'm sorry.
I'm Mason.
Francesca.
Louis.
Aiden. Look at Aiden's got his hair done.
Aiden's a little rock star. He's got a hammer. That's an old school Hammerjacks t-shirt, too. That is awesome, dude.
So how has life changed since last we talked to you? You've got the EP done, obviously, but you've played out more, and you're winning contests. This is amazing.
Pretty awesome.
Now, so, ladies, gentlemen, what is the best part about being in a band? Francesca, let me ask you first.
Playing music.
Just playing.
Yeah.
Is playing live your favorite part, or is just playing in general?
I don't know.
Do you like playing live?
Yeah.
You don't get nervous yet?
No, not really.
Good for you. How about you, bro?
I like playing live. It's the coolest thing. You get to go up and you have an audience who really enjoys your music, and you get to do whatever you want.
Now, how old are you now?
I'm 11. I'm 12.
How many girlfriends you got? Don't lie to me.
Zero.
So smart, dude. You're so smart.
Yeah, you won't need them until you're unemployed and don't have a whole lot of money.
Look at that kid. God, if I could just go back in time and be him.
He's got it all laid out in front of him.
Look at the face on that kid, dude. Yeah. He's a beautiful boy.
Wow, this is getting creepy really fast.
Why is it creepy?
He's not a beautiful boy.
Is he not a beautiful boy?
I could go back in time.
And be him, you idiot. God, this is why people don't like you. You know that, right?
There's plenty of other reasons why.
Yeah, that too. So now, you were the little guitar virtuoso that I first saw up at... where was that thing?
Outlaw Jam.
And yeah. I remember when you guys first started, and I thought, all right, here we go. It's a bunch of kids.
And he's got a cool name. His name is Mason.
Yeah. And I thought, all right, this is going to be ridiculous. A bunch of kids. It's going to be horrible. Out of time. And as soon as you guys started playing, I can't remember what song. It was Crazy Train.
Oh, yeah.
That I remember because what did they start with?
It was Mississippi Queen.
Mississippi Queen, maybe. It got to the part of the solo, and I was just like, what the hell? You were like 9 at that time. I'm not kidding.
Yeah.
And just destroyed it. And then you did Crazy Train, and you ripped the soul, right? Didn't you do Crazy Train?
We did like Hot Blooded, and then like...
That was someone else.
Rock and Hoochie Coo.
No, it wasn't somebody else. Well, okay, maybe I'm getting them confused. But I just remember looking at you specifically and was just like, this is ridiculous.
How long have you been playing?
Oh, like 5 years now.
Nice.
He's 12. Been playing 5 years.
So with the EP, I'm
half my life
right
I've been playing
it's
the guitar.
Bad Seed Rising 606 EP. Are these all original songs?
Yeah, they're all
original. They are. So you guys have sat down, you've written some songs, and we'd love to hear you play. I see all of you have your instruments. What would you like to play for us today?
Dark Before the Dawn.
What is it?
It's called Dark Before the Dawn.
Dark Before the Dawn.
Yeah, that's not going to work for us.
All right. You guys are going to do that one live?
Yeah, sure.
That's right. Number 3 on the EP.
Yeah, and we're going to take a listen to something else when they're done, but this is Dark Before the Dawn, and it is, what's the name of the band? It confuses me.
Bad Seed Rising.
I always want to say Bad Moon Rising. Yeah. That's the thing, if it's Bad Seed Rising. All right, guys, take it away.
Just let me run. I can make it. I can
fight to be free.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, I did not know that that was going to come out of her, man.
I know. That's crazy, that isn't crazy. It? I know.
Bad Seed Rising is the name of the band, and it really is pretty amazing, the sound that you guys are already able to make at such a young age, and I can't wait to hear you when you're 30, but I have a feeling you're going to make it way
about
before
18.
Then. I was going to say, before that, they're going to make it way before that. So where can people get your CD? Because I'm already getting texts, where do I buy this?
Their Facebook, and you direct message a Facebook, we'll get a hold of you, we'll get you the CD.
Yeah, right. It's early in the stages right now. They'll get it all set
and
up.
And the Facebook is /Bad Seed Rising Band, and you can also go to, if I can read this, badseedrisingband.com, and that's where you can find them online.
Let's listen to a little bit of the CD. This is track 2, I Won't Be the One. That's amazing, guys.
It doesn't hurt that you have the Foo Fighters producer in the studio with you, too. Were you shy about it? I mean, were you like, wow, this is a guy that works with the Foo Fighters?
No, we were pretty chill. I mean, we shared chips.
Did he help write any of the songs, or did you already walk into the studio with everything prepared?
Yeah, he chipped in ideas.
Yeah.
He gave you some ideas. Yeah, that's a good way.
More
to
like
produce.
One arrangement and stuff, and yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Exactly.
And maybe a chord change here or there.
Yeah.
Who's the principal writer? Like in the band,
all of us.
Yeah,
that's
you guys wrote that.
Yeah, the way it works is pretty much someone will bring in like a riff, and we all kind of just work on it.
Who writes the lyrics?
Francesca.
Cause they're
Francesca.
How old are you, Francesca?
15.
Yeah, like you know what's amazing? You're writing adult lyrics. Like that's what's weird. You're not coming at it. No, I mean honestly, you know, you listen to this.
Yeah, the poppy stuff that they're playing on, like, the Disney Channel and all that
whatever,
stuff.
Whatever, right. I want to kiss you behind the bleachers.
Die! Yeah, these guys blow all those bands away.
It's not even close.
Not even close.
Well, and the fact that it's a female-fronted band, too, and I could easily say 10 years ago there weren't a whole lot of female-fronted bands, but the door's been kicked open. So you hear, Evanescence is in there, Hailstorm.
No, hey, Francesca.
Guano Apes and different things like that.
Is that Mom? Yeah. How's it going,
Mom? Look how proud she is.
I know. Oh, is that what you saw, Pride? I saw something else.
So check it out for yourself. They are online, badseedrisingband.com. You can also check them out at Facebook, Bad Seed Rising Band, there as well. Congratulations. We really, really hope to hear more from you guys. Can't wait for the full length.
If we don't hear anything more from them, there's something seriously wrong with this entertainment industry.
You're right. And you can
well, there
them.
Is something seriously wrong with the entertainment industry.
Make
is.
Sure you check them out October 26th at the Ravens Cheerleaders annual Rock the House charity event. It's going on at Rams Head Live. And that's also, they're at Mother's on the 26th. I'm sorry. And then
November
also
30th.
On November 30th, they're going to open for Loving the Lie, their EP launch party. So all of that is right there at their website. Check it out for yourself. Keep up the great work, guys and gals.
Thank you.
We will.
You guys are incredible.
Thank you.
Stay off the heroin, kids.
My God.
Stay off heroin?
Yeah.
Last time
the other stuff is cool, but the heroin.
What was it last time?
Stay away from the dope.
Right.
Yeah, well.
Now we're getting more specific.
Spiegel, giving advice to kids all over.
Supposed to stay away from the dope, but you sat right next to him.
Oh,
that's nice.
I got one more thing to say.
Yes, Francesca, whatever you'd like.
It's my mom's birthday today. Just
it is.
Happy birthday, Mama.
Happy birthday.
Hold on. Birthday kiss for Mom. No, I'm kidding. And Francesca, stay cool, okay? Don't, you know what I'm saying to you, girl. All right? Don't get caught. You got boys chasing you around like.
Oh, because these guys aren't going to get an ego on them?
Come on. No, listen. First of all, these three.
Yeah.
Look at me, Francesca. They always think that the girl's going to be the diva in the band. And look. Crybaby. Because you know why? They're guys. And listen,
men.
And they're talented. Exactly. See, you're getting it. I was in a band. I was a big crybaby. Every other guy in the band's a big crybaby. You got to hold it together. You be the boss.
I try to.
Look at all the parents like, why don't he shut up? Am I right, guys? Does she ever does she complain? She doesn't complain about nothing, does she? Ah!
That guy complains.
Yeah, exactly. Now, you guys, listen. Dude, could you totally, like, seriously think about this. Could you imagine if, like, say, just by some weird chance, they came out on, like, the Kids' Choice Awards or, like, the Disney Awards?
It's coming. It's
dude,
coming.
But they played, nobody knew who they were. The next day, they'd be the biggest thing in the world.
Yeah.
I'm going to make it happen.
Who's their manager?
We actually are represented by two gentlemen, Sterling McElwain. He's Chris Daughtry's manager.
Yeah,
Chris
they got
Daughtry?
Real.
What?
Yeah.
Look at these names.
Dude.
And then, Larry Mazur, he manages Lamb of God and Breaking
You
Benjamin.
Tell Larry Mazur, I'm serious. You tell Larry Mazur, he used to manage Kiss,
oh, yeah.
Motley Crue. You tell Larry, Mickey from Baltimore, Hammerjacks, said hi, and to tell his old ass to call me.
He has no idea who he is.
I absolutely know. Larry and I've been to dinner about five times.
I'm talking about he doesn't know who you are.
You got his number, I'll call him right now on the air. He'll know who the hell I am. Definitely. Yeah, I do. All right, guys. Thanks again. It was awesome.
No problem.
Oh,
you should be very proud, man.
Just
and I don't mean just mean playing.
Wonderful.
Songwriting's
day.
Brilliant. Congrats.